What is Mega Man's favorite vegetable? Broccoli. Welcome to the stream. Welcome to Mega Man 6. Welcome to what I plan to be our final night of Mega Man 6, if everything goes well. We're going to be finishing this game up tonight, the end of my first playthrough. We've already taken out all of the Robot Masters, and now we just have the Mr. X stages, and probably a set of Dr. Wily stages as well. If it follows the pattern that Mega Man games seem to always follow, then we've got maybe 6 to 8 stages left to complete. So we're going to see if we can get those done, and when we do, we're going to switch over and try out Wizards and Warriors on the NES. Big NES day for me. This is actually my second stream today. I was streaming earlier in the afternoon for 3 hours or something, playing Super C over and over and over again. Loose and Jelly, welcome in. First we're going to rock, then we're going to roll. Excellent. How perfect for this game. Oops. I was just a fraction of a second too late on the password button there. So, I've got a password for us to use, if I can find it in my tablet. Should do it. Wow. This game flashes an awful lot. Lots of bright flashing lights every moment. Okay, so I think these Mega Man heads mean these stages were cleared and had no items, and then we got all of the beat letters. So now we just have however many stages are hidden in here. Okay, 4 to start. What a weird way to show you beat the level. So, I think that the Mega Man heads aren't really that weird. It's kind of like him planting his flag, right? Like Mario takes down Koopa's flag and puts up his own. So if you beat the level, and it has nothing to find in it, it shows you a Mega Man head. If you beat the level and there is a secret that you didn't find, it puts nothing. It's just an empty box to let you know. And then if you beat the level and find the thing, it puts the letter in the box to remind you that you found the letter. Oh, I know how to take care of this guy. Perfect. Looks like we are required to use our jet. But the head is an extra life. Good point. That was close. That was awfully close. Hello, cows. Welcome in. Just getting started. I went live just a few minutes early. So we could use the jet to go up to that ladder, but I think the trickier challenge is going to be to bust open that glass. I don't even know if I can do it. Well, that didn't go very well. I do wish we didn't have to watch this little jet scene. It was going so well. Why did it have to crash? The purple city in the background of this level is nice. You know I love it. I love my purple backgrounds. Ah, it fell apart. Okay. So let me address this situation. I'll be right back with you. You know, my NES doesn't always crash. I was able to stream for over 3 hours earlier today. Not one crash. Tonight, it now just a couple hours later, it crashes in the first 10 minutes. Let's hope this is not going to be the theme of the night. Oh yeah, I like that city. Oh, so as I was saying, I wish we didn't have to watch this little animation every time we wanted to switch powers. Thank you. I'm really not convinced that I'm gonna be able to do this. Unless there's another power that breaks, glass, but I don't think there is. Welcome in, Greg. It's great to have you here. Great to see you again. Guess it was the start of that era. They were just so proud of their animations, they had to make you watch them every time. Like FF7 years later. I've never played FF7. But now I know. Now I know I gotta watch out for unskippable cutscenes when I eventually do get around to it someday, 20 years from now. Oops. That's not how I meant to do that. So my goal is to try and break the glass and see, to not really worry about whether or not I fall. Oh. I think I'm going about this all wrong. Nope, that didn't work. FF7 is a good game, but the animations and cutscenes are sometimes too abundant. I'm terrible at this. I hope there's something really good. I hope there's something really good behind that window, because I sure am struggling to get to it. Not that good at this game either. Alright, then I know I'm in good company. At least I've got that. It makes me want to cry. That works. You can actually change to the jet in midair. good to know. Midair changes. Fancy. Fancy indeed. Was so close. Oh, it's so close to having it. So far, this one puzzle here is the most difficult thing I've faced in the game. They just had to put those spikes there. I know. It's not bad enough that they give me moving platforms, but it's like, oh no, give them spikes too. And what I'm really afraid of is that I'm going to get over there and the reward's just going to be like something like, I don't know, something weak that I already have. Oh, my password doesn't save my E-tanks. I had a ton of E-tanks when we last left off. Now I've got zero. That's unfortunate. I knew I was messing that up as I did it. Oh. It's gonna be a long night. That didn't work. I've got to jump to it. I can't, because I got to have it charged. I've got to jump to it. I can't fly. Dizzle, welcome to the stream. Glad to have you here. Thank you kindly. There's got to be an easier way to do this that I'm just not aware of. No, that was my chance. Oh, what a calamity. All right, we're gonna do it. We know it's possible. I was so close that it has to be possible. You can't get that close and not be able to do it. Spikes there. If it weren't for the spikes, I would have it already. So hard. I mean, come on. They intended for children to be able to do this, right? I know I can do it. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, that feels good. What's our reward? That's it? It's just a whole bunch of these things? And an enemy taking away all my life? Come on, you gotta give me something better than that. Hey, thank you for the trophies. So far, those trophies are a better reward than what I've actually found. Okay. That's a pretty good reward. And we skipped most of the level. So I've pulled that challenge off. I don't think I'll be doing that again, but it's nice to have done it. Okay, like a ride the thing enemy? Nope. I see by your stream description, your next game is Wizards and Warriors. You know it. Cool, I used to be able to beat that game with no problem, but now since I haven't played the game in so long, probably not anymore. I don't know, I've never played it before. I did read the instruction manual, so I have a little bit of knowledge about what the game might be like, but I've never actually seen the game. Thank you. The manual makes it sound really good, so I'm hoping it lives up to the expectations that have been set for me. Hooray. I kind of see that enemy is only weak, you know, like at certain times, but... The window for when that area was weak was so narrow. Cool. Accidental secrets. I mean, I think... This game makes me sad. It keeps crashing. Alright, well, let me step away and I'll try and fix it. Okay, well, let's see how far we get this time. I mean, already I'm seeing a little bit of a deterioration, so I don't think very far. It's probably not even worth a try. Hang on a moment. Thank you for your patience, my friends. Your willingness to endure this frustration is admirable. I don't know what it is. My Mega Man 6 cart is so far the least reliable game in my collection. Tunberry, good to see you again. Welcome to Mega Man 6 and a whole lot of me resetting the cartridge. It's just, I don't know how many times it's going to take before we get lucky and I get it seated in there just right so that it has a good read. Sparrow, welcome to the stream and thank you for the pistachios. That one tried to escape. I usually have a little bit of trouble with a lot of my NES carts, but the Mega Man 6 cart, it really takes the cake. You remember the frustration all too well. Okay, well, we know what that secret is now, and we also know that it's not so valuable that I need to waste all my time trying to get it again. The extra lives are nice, but I waste a lot of lives just trying to get into that area, so at the end of the day, they're not as much of a benefit as they may seem. Ooh, is it an E-Tank? Looks like it was. Nice. Whoa, look at those death spikes. Thanks for the beginner's trap, Capcom. Hello again, Derek. Great to see you. Mega Man time, yep. We're struggling to get the cartridge to behave. They're moving so fast. I gotta say, this, as bosses go, this one is pretty underwhelming. Fingers crossed that it behaves. Just watching some Batman the Animated Series on HBO. I love Batman the Animated Series. That's my favorite incarnation of Batman and his world. Having issues with the game, that's putting it very mildly. I've only had like 7 crashes tonight. 7,000. Ooh. I better keep an eye out. There's gonna be spikes in the next one of those, I bet. Yep, look at that. Spikes right there. Waiting for me. Thank you. Good thing I was wearing the jetpack, because picking up that collectible, that health drop or whatever it was, it ate my jump input. That's not good. Your favorite Batman were the two Michael Keaton movies, the 80s and the 90s. I like those well enough. I'm not crazy about Jack Nicholson as the Joker, just because I'm not really crazy about Jack Nicholson in any of his roles. He's one of those actors that, like, he can't disappear into a role for me. Whenever I watch Jack Nicholson in a role, I just see Jack Nicholson. I don't see the character that he's supposed to be playing. So I don't really like him in anything. I really like Batman Returns. Because it's dark and weird and cold. Most importantly, it's cold. This boss is a nightmare. You like both of his movies too? Boy, I hate this. This is not fun. And now I'm dead. Danny DeVito as the Penguin helps too. It's a lot of fun. You love Jack as the Joker, but to each their own. Yeah, that's fine. I got no problems if you like it. I just don't get into it. I'm out of powers. There's not really a lot of worth that I can do at this point. Let me just wait for the inevitable. Never mind. No. Oh, yes. Nightman's power wins the day. Oh, I knew I always wanted to be a knight. Like mostly all the actors who played the Joker. They're all so different. Hey, we got a raid coming in. Oh, what have I done? What have I done? I've trapped myself. Just gonna give them a moment to get past the commercial. Hello, Key. Welcome in. Thank you for the raid. Good to see you again. So welcome to Mega Man 6. Welcome to you and welcome to your friends. Grim Creeper, welcome to the stream. We're pretty far along in Mega Man 6 here. This is my first playthrough. So I don't know everything that's awaiting us, but I'd say we've got probably 4 to 6 more levels left. And I give you a heads up, the game has been crashing a lot tonight, so you may see a lot of glitches. You may see me having to get up and clean my cartridge a lot, because I don't know. I mean, I don't think that cleaning is really helping it. I just think that seating it in the console differently might help, but it's been behaving for a little while now, so we may be past the worst of it. Forgot to put your own raid message. For stopping by earlier tonight. No problem. I wish I could have stayed longer, but I only had a short amount of time to stop and eat before stream. Or between streams. And also, I haven't played Ori yet, and I think I might want to, so I can't watch anyone play too much of it. I hope it went well for you, though. That's what I get. That's what I get, right? Well, let's go up here and get this E-Tank. Even though I'm very, very close to the grave. You got really stuck. Hey, I get stuck and lost in games all the time. I was playing Ocarina of Time on stream, and I got stuck in Gerudo's Fortress for like 3 hours. And I've played that game several times. So it's really inexcusable. I appreciate actually running it on the original hardware. It's what Dr. Light would want. Hey, thank you. Yeah. I don't really do like emulators and that kind of stuff myself. I might play something like in a port or a virtual console if I have to. But I'm in a really fortunate position. I have a fairly large collection of retro games in their original form, and so Figure I'd need to make use of them as much as I can. There's no sense in having all this stuff if I don't use it. Alright, we're gonna go across the hard way this time. Yeah. Mr. X is gonna be shaking in his boots when he sees how bold I am. Not even using the jet power. He doesn't know what he's up against. See, there's some breakable blocks, but I don't know if it's worth it to go down there. Probably is. Alright, let's backtrack. One of my mods had to look up something for you, but we got through it, and what a rush, this one part. I won't spoil it. Thank you. Yeah, I don't know when I'll ever get around to it, but Ori's one of those games that I think I might want to play. Have you ever seen the really weird version of the Joker from the Batman animated show? I haven't seen anything from that show, Derek. There's no reward. It's just a shortcut. Well, I didn't need that. It's so weird. You think I'll like it? I hope I do. But yeah, like I said, I don't know when I'm going to get to it. Okay, now you see here, this is a situation where you're forced to use the jet. If you can make this jump without the jet, then my hat's off to you, because look at this. Metroid Dread, you want to play for yourself? Yeah. I don't blame you. I don't blame you, Derek. Although, just so you know, I don't usually play new games on release, so depending on when you pick it up, you might be able to drop by. So far, my general policy for new releases is that I tend to play them about a week after they come out, so that people have time to play them themselves if they want to. Wish we get a new Star Fox on Switch. Yeah, I don't expect that. I think we might get a Star Fox on the Switch 2 if we're lucky. If we're really lucky. I don't think that, I don't expect that Miyamoto has recovered from Star Fox Zero yet. Although, I mean, we are going to get Star Fox in the Nintendo 64 collection on the Switch. We're going to get Star Fox 64. And I mean, if they made a new Star Fox game, it'd probably just be a remake of Star Fox 64 anyway. So... Hey, Grim Creeper, thank you for the follow. Greatly appreciated, my friend. Thank you so much. I'm gonna pay off Metroid with your next check. Yeah, I'm not really concerned about having to lock down a copy of Metroid. I don't think it's gonna like sell out on day one or anything. You just want it on day one? Yeah. I don't blame you. I don't blame you. I'm looking forward to it myself. Oh no, that's terrible. That's terrible. Don't fall back down there. Next game you're getting is the new Castlevania Advance Collection. Yeah, so the only game from that I don't already own is Dracula X, and so I'm just I'm not in a rush to pick it up. I probably will pick it up because I think I'll really like Dracula X. I think that'll make it worth it for me. But oh no, I can't go back. I wanted to see what was up top on that ladder. But I'm not in a rush to pick it up. They knew what they were doing. They put that bullet right in my path. Okay, let's. Well, this is my last life. I like the design of these robots. They're kind of cool. They're pretty simple, but I still like them. Nice. How'd the game know? How did it know? All I wanted was a 1-up. And look at that, I got it. Oh no! You see what I did there? I knocked that block in my way. I can't get the E-Tank now. This game really likes setting little traps for you like that. You used to have the GBA and the Castlevanias, but you lost them in a move. That's upsetting. I've moved so many times. I've got so many boxes that I haven't unpacked in 12 years. Because I just keep moving, so what's the point of ever fully unpacking? And so I've got all these boxes that are filled with stuff that I don't even know that I own. It's wild. This isn't so bad so far. My scheme for world domination has failed, but I still have enough power to destroy you. Oh, thanks. Oh, no. You don't say Mr. X was Dr. Wily all along? Let the final battle begin. Gasp and shock and horror. I mean, I definitely think the collection's worth $20. I'd say it's probably even worth, you know, maybe as much as 30 if you've never played any of the games before. But I don't know if... See, for me, I'm just buying it for one game. But now, if you've never played any of them before, especially, it's definitely worth it. The skull house is pretty cute. Feels like there should be a secret up here. Whoa. Yuck! You see that? I hit the like very tip edge of the spike. And I was even moving because I was afraid there was going to be spikes down there before I even fell. Amazon's doing their own Lord of the Rings show. Don't know how good it will be. Yeah, I don't really have any interest in it. I didn't even finish watching all the Hobbit movies. I'm a pretty big Lord of the Rings fan, but you know, we got three really good movies. That's good enough for me. I don't need all the other stuff. I think the Lord of the Rings has already done as good as it will be. But I don't think they're remaking the story of the Lord of the Rings. I think that it's like expanded universe kind of stuff. From what I understand. But again, I think it's well established that I don't really go in for the big universes. I like my media franchises to be very very small universes. I just want a few pieces of media in every franchise. I don't need a whole lot. Oh, there's a secret up there. Okay, so if we get a game over, at least we'll get to check out what that secret was that I keep missing. Someone need to tell that guy he's facing the wrong way. You slept through one of the Hobbit movies in theaters. I don't think I've ever fallen asleep in a movie theater. As much as I love the books, the movies weren't your jam. Yeah. I kind of felt the same way. I don't know. I watched the first Hobbit movie. I thought it was pretty good. I thought it looked terrible. That, like, the frame rate. They shot on, like, 48 frames a second or 36 or something. It looked awful. Movies are shot at 24 frames for a reason. This is the exact same password I already had. What? No, this isn't possible. What? How can it give me the same password for a different level? This doesn't make any sense. It must not let you save during these stages. Oh man. Double password. That's it. Something's not right here. Hello, Colossum. Welcome to the stream. And I see we have a bean redemption. So let's take care of that, too. I'm just beside myself. I can't believe it. It just gave me the same password for this level. That's the same password I had 5 levels back. Something is wrong here. I can't grab just one. Got one. Here we are. Oh my. Well, this bean looks like a disaster. It's So this is socks or Tutti Frutti. So those are my choices. So the Tutti Frutti bean puzzles me. Because I thought for the longest time that the Tutti Frutti bean was bubblegum flavored. But now I think, if I understand it correctly, the Tutti Frutti is a mystery bean that tastes like any of the other good beans. So it could be socks or anything good. If I understand this bean correctly now. And it's bubblegum. And bubblegum isn't even an option in the box. What is going on? This is why I thought the Tutti Frutti was always bubblegum. The world is too mysterious for me to understand. But I'm glad I didn't have to eat socks. I feel like you've cursed the beans. See, the last time I got a Tutti Frutti bean, I said that the Tutti Frutti is bubblegum when it's a good flavor. And then when I ate it, it wasn't bubblegum, it was pear. And so I was in, so then I was like, oh, that's how the Tutti Frutti bean works. It's always a random good flavor. But this time it was a good flavor that's not even in the box, which is bubblegum. No. Yeah, I think it was pear last time. Still didn't get the secret. Oh, you know what? I need the jet to do that. Okay, next time. Next time we come through here, we're getting that secret. Looks like there should be something up here, but there's not. Still have my E-tanks, that's good. I don't think I've used a single E-tank in this game yet, though, so. Not that I'm above it. I'll definitely use an E-tank if I'm feeling trapped. But I like to put in a solid effort without them before we resort to that. This is not the move. This is not the move. Maybe nothing that this guy is especially weak to. Dino. Sorry, cows. It's him or me. Should have known, a spear to the face. He and I have the same weakness. Just glad we get to see him do what you gotta do. I appreciate your understanding. I like how one of the towers on Wily's fortress is a bone. Thank you for the trophies. Got a free E-tank over here. Gonna keep that in the pocket. Oh, it's a slippery here. Everything's frozen over. I like it. It's one of these rooms, huh? Let's see what this is all about. I think I just skipped the whole puzzle. This damage. Just damage boost through. Oh. Hey, not that guy looks like a platform. I can't use him as a platform. Okay, 3, 5, and a little thingamathing over there. I can remember that. As much as I love ice levels, I have a pretty strong dislike for ice physics. Alright, so here we go. We can see what we missed out on before. One, two, up, wait, up, down. One, two, up, wait, up, down. Oh, he broke him. Oh, and he's really mad. I don't blame him. Ooh, another E-tank. Nice. Okay, so I thought I was supposed to use that guy as a platform to get up to this power, but I think I'm just supposed to fly very carefully. My heart sank a little when I ran off that platform there. I felt it was the right thing to do, but I was really scared to do it. Oh, interesting. Very interesting. I wonder what this thing is weak to. Not that. Not that. He's weak to the wind. Nope. I was gonna say, that fish can keep that thing. I don't want it. There appears to be only one way to proceed. Oh no. Oh no, it's the boss rush. Right. Well, I didn't learn what any of the bosses are weak to. Or if I did, I didn't remember. Most of them weren't a problem. I know I fought one or two bosses with their weakness, but they were, it was exceedingly few. Yeah, see how easy it was? He only drained half my health. Keep going around. Okay. Now, Nightman should be easy. He probably won't be, but he should be. I don't remember him ever doing that move before. Yeah, that's what I'm used to. The hardest thing about Nightman is his attack. It doesn't seem to have a set length. Like, he just throws it for however far or short he feels like. What are you doing, man? What? He went like 20 minutes without throwing an attack. How am I supposed to handle that? If he never, he figured it out. If he never lowers his shield, then he's never vulnerable. I've never seen him walk around aimlessly like that for so long. Centaur. I don't know if he turned invisible or if the game just glitched. Thank you. I'm in trouble. Look at that. Do you recognize that password? We've seen that before. That's the same one that I got at the beginning of the Wily stages. Yeah, there must be no passwords for the second part of the game here. I don't know. I know I'm getting different passwords, but I don't know what they could possibly mean. Because I'm also getting the same passwords in different situations. Start on the other side this time. Did we really fight this guy? I don't remember this guy at all. What is he? Destroyed. All right. I'm gonna experiment with the powers. I don't know if I just didn't use that properly or what. It seemed like it was doing, you know, a sizable chunk of damage to him. But it wasn't enough to take him out. That doesn't bother. Oh yeah, this guy was easy though. I don't need to use a power up against this guy. He was so easy, in fact, that he's destroying me. Naturally. I'm terrible at this. I'm a joke. All right, let's see if he's weak to the wind. What is going on with these guys? We're gonna be here a very long time. So, I don't know if they've made the Robot Masters harder for the rematch or what it is, but I remember them all being so easy the first time, and now I don't know what is different, but the rematches are brutal. There's no way that this guy moved this fast the first time we played this. Awful. I got no lives, so it doesn't really matter. That this guy was weak to the plant thing. Of course, that requires standing right next to him to use it, so. I don't know. I don't know what is happening to me, my friends. I've fallen apart. The worst part about that is now you know that we can't beat the robots because I've already lost a life. So everything else I do now is pointless. It's someone running a timer. Look at how long it takes him to attack. What? Okay, so let's see. What were these? Spear, Blizzard, Mace. No, not the Mace, Tomahawk. These guys have all really got me despairing. Remember who was down here. This guy. So yeah, I think this guy's weak to the plant, but to use it, I gotta stand right next to him. Spirits are low. Spirits are low, my friends. I thought all these robots were so easy the first time. Have they gotten so much better, or have I gotten so much worse? start with this guy because he's kind of a nightmare. I thought the powers are supposed to make the battle easier, but I mean, it's not doing anything. In fact, I'm dead. I'm frustrated. I'm so frustrated. The power that this guy is weak to, all it does is guarantee that we take a hit, because it makes you stand right next to him. So what is even the point? It might as well damage us to use it. How is he not weak to this? Then who's weak to this? No one? Sorry for all the flashing, but not much I can do about it. This guy is weak to the mace. Didn't know he was weak when he jumped. I don't remember who is behind which door. It's Plant Man. Oh my goodness, what a struggle. Oh, that was not fun. Yeah, we've seen one of these before. The cyan, lime, and magenta color scheme is fun. Hello, loyal to soil. Welcome in. Great to have you here. I'm a bit in despair. The Robot Master rematch really took its toll on me. Oh my. This thing appears to have a manageable pattern. No, I'm not ready for this. Okay, well, phase one seems to be manageable. Phase two, I don't know about. No. Oh no. And then, you know, there's phase three. Oh. Yuck. Why can't I jump? Give me something good. Take it. Concerned. I think I've probably already taken too much damage. Yuck. Okay, he's up above me, so... Yuck. Wily. I can't stand you, man. I was trying to slide, it just wasn't working. It just wasn't working. I like that this battle seems to be learnable. Second phase, less so than the first, but... Maybe. I don't know how to avoid those circles that he puts out, because they seem to do something different every time, and there's not a warning. I guess I just have to get lucky. That's no fun. Thank you. wonder if I can call in Beat to help me. Oh no. I don't even think he's weak to this. Oh yeah, he is. I think he's weak to everything. Okay, so you gonna get up and run away? Oh, I think not. All right. Victory. Dr. Wily now rules over a prison cell. Oh my. What an ending. Oh. I don't feel victorious. I feel relieved. This game really started to wear me down at the end there. Why are we watching the snowman dance around? Lizard man, that is. Hello, Gamer Jam. Welcome to the stream. The episode of Malcolm in the Middle where Reese punches a bug zapper. I don't really know that show. I probably saw an episode or two back in the day, but that doesn't sound familiar to me. If he felt worn down afterwards, though, I can relate. Oh, that was a struggle there at the end. This game went from really, really easy to really rough. I'm glad we played it, and I definitely had fun in a lot of places, but it got me feeling kind of low there at the end. You do enjoy games that cause suffering. I guess that's true. I guess when you think about it like that, this must be one of my favorite games ever. Had a lot of suffering come out of nowhere. I kind of like the jet and the power punch abilities that they give you in this game. They're kind of fun abilities, but at the same time, I feel like, you know, all the puzzles that they put into the game that you have to use one of those abilities to solve might have been more rewarding if they replaced those with puzzles that you solve using the gained abilities instead. Because aside from the tomahawk, I can't really think. Let's see, there are a couple enemies that the tomahawk was really useful against in the main levels. There was one spot that I remember where you used the fire ability to melt an ice patch. I don't recall any of the other abilities ever being useful in a regular level. I mean, there might have been spaces where they are, but they didn't seem mandatory ever, so I never figured it out if there were those places. And that's kind of a shame. I wish we got more use out of the abilities. But I feel like I always feel like that in a Mega Man game. So, what a ride. What a ride. But we're finished with this one, my friends. Thank you for coming along on this journey with me. We're going to do something else now. I'm going to take a short BRB. And when I come back, we're going to switch gears and switch games. We're going to move on over to Wizards and Warriors on the NES. I'm not even sure what kind of game this is. I've never played it before. I've never seen it played. I read the manual, which makes the game sound really interesting, but it also doesn't really tell me what type of game it is at the same time. From the description, it sounds like it could be kind of Zelda-like, where you, like, kind of find keys and solve puzzles, but it also seems like it's probably kind of side-scrollery, so I don't really know what we're in for, but I'm hoping it's going to be a good time. But that's what we're going to do when I get back, so I'll go ahead and tell you thank you very much for viewing the stream this far, coming on this adventure, and helping me continue to keep going when my spirits are down. I really appreciate having you here, and if you want to stick around for just a few minutes, I'll be back with you very shortly, my friends.